I wonder what this one's gonna do.
Oh man, that is absolutely delicious.
G'day there everyone, welcome to Movie Studio Zen, my name's Derek. In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create magic strawberries. I'm not kidding. To do this tutorial, you're going to need SoundForge Audio Studio and Movie Studio Platinum. So if you own Movie Studio Suite 13 or version 12, 11, blah, 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 all of the Suite versions come packaged with SoundForge Audio Studio, which is a standalone audio editing program. So in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use both programs at the same time. We're going to open up just the audio component in SoundForge, do some work in it, save it, and have all those changes automatically update into Movie Studio very, very easily. So the first thing we need to do is tell Movie Studio what our preferred audio editor is. So go to Options, Preferences, Audio. And if where it says Preferred Audio Editor, if you haven't set it already, it'll be blank. Select Browse, then go to This PC. If you're on Windows 7, I think it says it's a computer or my computer. Open up the C drive. Open up Program Files x86. Open up the Sony folder. And here you should find SoundForge Audio Studio 10. Open it up. And look for Audio Studio 100.exe. Double click that. Click Apply and OK. So whatever project you're working on, get it going on the timeline. And before you go any further, make sure you actually save the project and that it's saved into a folder that makes sense to you. Just before we open up the audio file in SoundForge, you can see here that I've added some regions. So these regions are just little visual guides for me to know where I want to add my sound effects. So I've got a section here, section one, section two, and there's also a section at the end which I haven't marked yet. And I wanted to show you how to create a region. So you just drag out above the timeline and then press R for rabbit on the keyboard. And we've got a region. Okay, so next step is to open up in SoundForge. So click on top of the audio track, not the video, the audio. Right click and then select Open Copy in Audio Editor. Don't use that first one, Open in Audio Editor. Okay, that's not a good method. Always do Open a Copy. Okay, so with a bit of luck, SoundForge Audio Studio has opened up for you. If it didn't, refuses to open, you could have a files permission problem on your computer. If that happens, just let me know and I can send you some instructions on how to fix that. So we'll get rid of this window here, press close. And there's a couple of things we need to set up before we get going. I go to Options, Preferences, Audio, and change audio device type to Windows Classic Wave Driver. Then make sure that default playback device looks correct for your computer. Also check that the default recording device also looks good for your computer. Remember, everyone's computer is going to be slightly different. Click Apply. Okay. Next thing to do is let's get this desktop looking a little bit less primitive. So we'll go to View, Window Layouts, Audio Editing. And a final little tweak I like to do is click on File Properties, grab hold of the handle, the row of vertical dots, and just drag it across. So we've got three distinct windows here. And we can make this a bit bigger if you want. For another thing I want to explain to you so that you understand is quickly go back to Movie Studio so that you understand what files are working here. So when we opened it up in SoundForge, Movie Studio rendered a new audio wave file, which you can see here, and it's also located on the timeline. If you go to View and make sure Active Take information is turned on, that'll make sure you see the descriptions here of your media files. So what's setting this new file, which has replaced the original audio for the video, is what we are editing with in SoundForge. So the first step I like to do is with my rough regions here, the areas that I want to change, I want to roughly transfer these regions into SoundForge. So that's 25. When you're dragging out a region here, we've got a left channel and a right channel. To do both together in synchronization, you need to drag on the center line. Okay. I will be making more in-depth tutorials on this program in the near future. Today, I just wanted to dive straight in and do something interesting. So quickly, at the top here, we've got processes, effects, tools, effects favorites, options. Effects favorites, that's going to look different for everyone. I've got a lot of programs installed on my computer. So what's happening is they're infiltrating this effects list. For most people, you probably wouldn't have much listed here. But how I'd like to apply effects is go effects favorites, Sony. And I like this list here because it shows a combination of everything from all these different separate menus. So the first effect I'm going to apply is pitch shift. Now pitch shift, when you shift the pitch up, that's how you create that Alvin and the Chipmunks effect. So I'm going to take this section a third up. And we can preview it.
Oh man, that is magic, man.
And if you're happy with it, you can press OK. Oops, I got ahead of myself. I forgot to do something. So I'm going to press cancel. I forgot to transfer those regions. Oh man, it's OK. So the step I forgot to do is after I've dragged it out, press R on the keyboard for region. Quickly go back here. Region 2 begins at 56. So that's that about here. Yep. And how long did that go for? 56 to 102. Oops. Okay, that's pretty good. Press R on the keyboard for region. And the final one starts at 117. Close enough. Okay, half a region. Okay, now we can get cracking. So I'll drag out a region again. Effects favorites, Sony, bit shift, and select a third up. Now, if I just press OK, this applies it, but watch what happens. You'll see that the whole timeline shrinks. Now that's bad because if we import this back into Movie Studio, it means the audio is going to go out of sync with my lips, which is going to look weird. So I'm going to press Control Z on the keyboard, go back in time. Effects favorites, Sony, bit shift. And there's a setting here you can turn on to stop it, to make it play back at the same original playback rate. So we're going to go preserve duration, and I'm going to select speech 1, 2, 3. I'm going to do speech 2. Preview it.
Oh man, that's
pretty good. So I'm going to select OK, and notice that it didn't change in time length. Okay, let's do the second section. This time I'm going to apply pitch shift again, This time I'm going to go a fifth up, so even faster.
Oh man, that is absolute.
Okay. But on this second one, I'm going to apply a second effect as well. So, effects favorites, Sony. This time I'm going to add, where are we? Chorus. And let's try fast, heavy chorus. That sounds interesting. Do preview.
Oh man, that is absolute.
Now, I can select bypass and hear what it sounded like before.
Oh man, that is. Oh man.
So it adds just a little bit extra flavor to it. Okay. And for the final section, I've got something prepared. I'm going to go pitch shift again. This time, I'm going to go a third down. So let's see what that preserve duration. Let's do preview.
Oh man, that is crazy.
Okay, I like that. I'm going to go okay. Also going to apply a secondary effect. And this time I'm going to do reverb. Let's do cathedral. And let's preview it.
Oh man, that is crazy.
Okay, that's good. Let's do okay. Okay, I'm pretty happy with that. So, when you've finished, go to File and just press Save. Now, open up Movie Studio. And here's where the magic's happened. So, let's go to our section one. And what should have happened is this file here is now updated with new information.
Oh man, that is magic, man.
Cool. So it's worked. Something that I like to do continuously is keep saving the project. So I'm going to go save. Save as. So we don't lose anything that we've already done. And even though this tutorial is a little bit long, I don't mind. Don't think you'll mind either. I want to do one final thing to really make this video pop, to make it really extra crazy. So on my regions here, I'm going to press S for split so that we've got separate little sections. This is a bit of a ghetto style thing I'm doing right now, but you'll understand in a second. Okay, so I want to apply a video effect as well to really make this whole weird magical thing come to life. So I got to go video effects tab. Going to go to Sony, and I'm looking for, which one will I do? Color curves, I think. So I'm going to start off, I'm going to put infrared effect. Yep, that's good. For my second section, I'm going to go blues and yellows. And for my third one, I'm going to go night. But I'm going to also add some. Where are we here? Let's go really crazy. And add some blue. Then I'm going to go brightness and contrast. And jack up the brightness. Maybe that's not working. I don't know, that's sort of what I want. That'll do. Obviously, I'd do it a little bit better if it was for real, but this is just a tutorial, so I don't want to get bogged down. Okay, let's do another save as. And if everybody's ready, let's watch Magic Strawberries and see what the whole production actually looks like. So we'll go full screen. Switch your view and let's press play.
G'day there, everyone. How's everyone going? In my spare time, one of the things I love to do is genetic engineering of strawberries. And I've just got my first batch here, so I thought just in case something goes wrong, I better, put it on camera. So here goes anything.
Oh man, that is magic, man. That is absolutely beautiful. That is magic, man. Absolutely beautiful. I think I'll try another one.
I wonder what this one's gonna do.
Oh man, that is absolutely delicious.
I think I'll try just one more. Well, this is only a little one. Doesn't mean its magic's going to be anything less.
Oh man, that is crazy. Anyway, I can't wait to see what the chilies are going to do. That was crazy, man.
Okay, so there, that is magic. Magic strawberries. So if you've got kids, this could be a fun little tutorial to do with your kids. Make a fun little Christmas video, something like that. Okay, so I hope you liked that tutorial. I certainly did. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And I'll see you in the next tutorial. Bye.